Blog Talk Radio.
You're tuned into In5D Radio, the next dimension in radio, where we bring you the hottest, in-depth, spiritual, metaphysical, esoteric conversations and news. Get ready for spirit, body, and mind to expand in 3, 2, 1.
Namaste and welcome to In5D Radio, coming to you from the 99% Quartz Crystal Sands of Sarasota, Florida, every Monday night at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, and 12 a.m. midnight in the UK. I'm your host, Gregg Prescott from In5D.com, and for the next 2 hours, we're going to be raising the vibration of the planet, galaxy, and universe. Tonight, Sharry Edwards from Sound Health Options .com joins us to tell us the truth behind sound and healing. But first, I'd like to bring on my co-host, coming to you from San Diego, California, psychic medium Sherrie Elisse. Hi, Sherrie. How are you tonight?
I'm very well, Gregg. Thank you. How about yourself?
I'm really excited about tonight's show, about sound healing and really getting the truth about this. And as a matter of fact, I see that Sherrie is in the queue, so let's bring her in.
All right. Well, tonight I'm going to be Sherrie Elisse, so that we're not calling on Sherrie and saying, because we have the greatest name in the world equally here. So tonight, In5D Radio has the honor of presenting research scientist and humanitarian Sherrie Edwards. Sherrie is the founder of Sound Health Options, as well as the director of the Institute of Bioacoustic Biology, which is on the forefront of energy medicine as an educational research institute dedicated to the pioneering and emerging field of human bioacoustics. Although she has attained a master's degree in education, she has placed her focus over the past 30 years on research, specifically in the area of bioacoustics. She has been named Scientist of the Year for 2001 by the International Forum on New Science for her excellence in research. Her actual experience in this area started much earlier, as her ears are actually constructed differently with a deformed cochlea and different voice abilities. This allowed her to be able to hear the frequencies that all of life gives off, including our plant and animal kingdoms. It was likely that her rare ability and inquisitive mind led her to an explanation thereof, which has brought her ultimately to the place that she's at now. She has been said to be the modern-day keeper of the information of the Holy Grail, with both her hearing, her rare hearing perception abilities, combined with her ancient knowledge of frequency and herb healing, best referred by this in a book entitled Tree of Life and Holy Grail by Sylvia Frankie. She is somehow able to tap into the stream of consciousness to download information. And she's a true humanitarian working on behalf of all sentient beings on this planet in bringing us to the frequencies of the future so that we are able to heal ourselves at the root cause within our own capabilities and our own control. She makes her voice analysis software free for download, and there's an accompanying 72-page guide to understanding how to do the work so that this technology, which she the people that she works with have devoted much of her life to creating, will go straight to the people, and that's exactly where she wants it to go. Privilege and honor to introduce our beautiful in all ways guest, Sherrie Edwards. Welcome, Sherrie, to In5D Radio.
Hi, Gregg. Sherrie, that was a wonderful introduction. Thank you.
Oh, well, thank you.
It's absolutely great.
I was on mute. I was just enjoying that introduction and just so lost in that welcome to In5D Radio, Sherrie. Thank you so much for being our guest. Now, can you explain maybe to our listeners a little bit more maybe of something that Sherrie didn't cover about how you came into this field? Because I know it's a fascinating story about your autoacoustic hearing ability and how you turned that into the current program that you're using.
Well, it was a great introduction. I think the only pieces that left out, Sherrie and you both are very familiar with the idea of psychic ability, knowing something about people. So psychic is, by definition, means knowing that you know something, but not knowing how you know it. So one of the things that was happening to me when I was very young and scared my family and those around me is that I knew things that I wasn't supposed to know. And people thought I was eavesdropping or whatever. But it, we came to find out when I started to work in a speech and hearing department that I was actually hearing a sound coming out of people's ears. Now, they thought that was just a manifestation of the eardrum and whatever, but it turns out that it's an oto, O-T-O meaning ear, otoacoustic emission, and it's a holographic sound representation of what's going on in your brain. So I think a lot of people know about psychic ability from someone's voice or their palm, which is all made of frequency anyway, or their handwriting, and it's just a way to drop into that other person's energy. And I was doing that from a very early age, and once I discovered that not everybody could do it and that people were very afraid of me, I decided to go about proving that this was an ordinary thing. And so I set up research projects trying to determine that I was normal. What a silly thing to do. So we sort of got into it that way from the beginning of having my ears tested at the speech and hearing department where I was working. And they found out that I could hear off the scale, like dog whistles. And this guy who was, I was so lucky that this guy was testing my ears. And he said, your hearing's off the scale. Tell me what you're hearing. What does it sound like? So I did one of these sounds, which you guys, you heard Gregg in class last week, I think. Mm-hmm. And he nearly dropped to his knees. He had high blood pressure. And he said, he was also a student of the samurai warrior histories. And he said, I think what you've just done is drop my blood pressure. I felt it drop. And that's what samurai warriors did right before they attacked an opponent. So I think you've tapped into this ancient way of feeling someone else's energy. And so we set up a research project at the university, because I was also going to school, with the School of Hearing and Speech Sciences, School of Music, School of Interpersonal Communication, where I was attending, and one other one, which I've totally forgotten at this point. But we found out that we could control people's blood pressure by as much as 20 points, which means we could kill them with sound. And from there, it just kind of snowballed once we published these papers, and people said, oh, we got to know about this, but only Sherrie can do it. And I thought, you know, and I was really young, but I thought, I'm going to die, and then this is going to die with me. This is too important. The people need this. This is our history. We forgot this somehow. And so I put it all in computer programs, and so everybody can do it and have dominion over their health and know who they are, and it just sort of created itself. I'm just along for the ride.
I'm so fascinated. I really, really am. And so many, it's, you know, it's so similar to myself as well, because I'm also a psychic medium, and I grew up very similar to you in being able to hear plants and snails and everything talking to me, but I never understood how I was hearing it. I thought it's, you know, psychic, but, you know, I didn't quite understand that, you know, maybe I was picking up their, you know, their frequency. So what you're saying, it's so interesting to me, because I've always wondered also how I've been able to do this.
When you were growing up and you knew this stuff?
You know, what was weird was that I was able to mind read pretty well, and I could pick up people's thoughts. And a lot of times people have very weird thoughts, and sometimes they're not very nice either. I was at the same time very outgoing. I was also very introverted because I put up a wall because mm-hmm. I didn't want to hear all their stuff. So I wasn't very weird, because I think I kept a lot of it to myself, and I had a fake exterior.
I think people fear it when they think you're going to drop into their privacy and know what they're thinking, because privacy has become such a revered thing because people are manipulating and managing other people's lives, the government and the pharmacy companies, and they're all trying to spin and put one over on us. So it became that you didn't want people to read you, so we sort of closed down that piece of us. I want to help people reopen it because it does create the fear. And I will bet you, Sherry, that you are reading the sounds out of their ears, because you can even pick up words. My husband and I have this kind of strange relationship where I can read words out of his head. And one day I said, what does hyperbole mean? Well, I said, what does hyperbole mean? Because I saw that neon lights above his head. And he thought, you mean hyperbole? And I said, okay, hyperbole, but he didn't say it out loud. And he said, come here a minute. And that was the word he was reading in a magazine article. So if you are clear yourself, and it, for a good psychic, you have to be clear of all the garbage and oughts and shoulds, you can go in and pick that up. But it also means that whoever you're dealing with, they can't hide from you. But, you know, one of the weirdest things is people think that I'm going to use that information in some way. And you just have to be very thin-skinned to pick it up and very thick-skinned to be able to handle it. Like you said, people weren't very nice. One of the hardest things I had to do was refrain from telling my daughter she was pregnant until she found it out. So sometimes it's hard to live in that mediumship where you know things and you can feel energy and try to maintain man's law at the same time you're trying to manage this God's law of enlightenment and knowing things that even people don't know about themselves. So you've already lived this life.
Well, I'll tell you, and I can tell the listeners right now that I saw your nano voice on the course over last week, and Sherry is coming from the heart. She's very well balanced, and she's doing this for humanity and for that sole reason. She's a true warrior, and we need more people like Sherry in this world.
Well, thank you, Gregg. Would you talk a little bit about class? Because we have other classes coming up, and I really want to share and spread the word about all of this.
Oh, definitely. What would you like to? Well, we can talk a little about what happened last week, if you'd like.
Okay.
Kendra Gilbert is a licensed massage therapist, and she was over here with me taking the 2-day class that you offered. Before we did the class, she worked on my back on my sciatica nerve issue. And she knew every muscle that was out of place in me. And we did the nano voice in class. Actually, you did the nano voice on me in class and the abacus program, and then ran it through your software. And everything you said, she confirmed. And it was to a T. Everything that she knew about every muscle that was out of place, you knew through that software. And it was absolutely amazing.
Was she surprised that it came out of your voice?
Well, I'll tell you what. We've been experimenting on one another, and her husband, and my girlfriend, and we've been doing this back and forth, and everything we've done is to a T. Whether it's the nano voice or the software, everything is coming out amazingly accurate.
And it was a 2-day course, and you got software, and you got a textbook. How much did it cost you, Gregg?
Absolutely nothing.
I love that piece. That's my wish for the world.
I love you for doing that for us. Thank you.
My idea of being rich is to be able to give away anything that I want to give away. And it just makes me happy to think about it.
You know, it's interesting because I've been experimenting on everybody I can find on this. I even have a 9-month-old German Shepherd puppy who sleeps under a 6-foot pyramid. And I used the nano voice on him, and as it turned out, his bark was in the keys of A and A sharp, which basically says he's spiritual, he takes care of the needs of others, he's highly intuitive, you know, along that line. So actually, my question to you would be, if the nano voice is only interpreting sound, not and not the words, then can the nano voice actually be used on animals as well?
Absolutely. And A and A sharp also means that he is he a Capricorn or a Sagittarius, by the way?
He's actually a Virgo, born on September 1st.
Oh,
Yep.
You know, that Virgo is an F. And then the A and A sharp are Capricorn and Sagittarius. I think this is how astrology originally got started, by reading the movements of the planets and hearing us influenced by the planets. And I think astrology had such a strong hold on who we are. But we look at everybody's sound. A and A sharp is about eyes and about immune system, spirituality, loving. Are either of you or your girlfriend Capricorn or Sag?
Yeah, she is. She's a Sagittarius. My girlfriend is.
So does he have a great affinity to her?
He loves her. Yeah, he does. I never checked his rising and his ascendant, but I'm curious what that might be, if it is a Virgo or a Capricorn.
I just think we can explain so much in terms of the math of the world. It's a constant in every society. One and one is two. And almost everybody speaks. I don't know how to do some of those Australian click, click, click kind of speeches, but it's a verbalization. And we've just taken that math and been able to correlate it with birthdays and people you care about and toxins and allergies. Did we do the chocolate allergy test in your class?
I don't believe so, no.
I thought we were doing allergies. I can't remember. I think Megan was there.
I could have been online trying to get my serial codes when that was being covered.
Well,
I'd have to ask Kendra about that.
We took that little nano voice program, which is free for everybody that wants to go to the site and pull it down.
Tell the people your site right now, if you'd
like. Oh, soundhealthoptions, plural, .com, and go to downloads. And there's the little nano voice. And be sure to download all the posters and flyers and stuff that go with it. And I'll tell you another piece in a minute that's really, really important to you and to Sherry. But because we did allergies, we put the allergies software online for people. So right there under the downloads and the nano voice, which is a personality profiler that in this class, and there's copies of the class right there that people can watch and see how to do this. But we saw that chocolate was very good for this girl named Megan that was in the class. And it's just it's a free program. So people don't have to go get all these expensive allergy tests anymore. And you can test everything that you want to at home. But the next one down that's for free is radiation exposure. And I just looked at the map before we came on. And Florida right now is red, and so is the west coast of the United States.
What's causing the red in Florida?
The radiation from Fukushima.
Wow.
And on that download, we have charts for people that if this is in your voice, this is the nutrient that will counter it, and this is what it's fighting with inside your body, so you need more of that. But think about, here's free software. You test someone's voice. You find out if they've been exposed to radiation. You help them with the nutrients. Right there is the flyer and the information for them. They go help themselves, because in our clinic, we are seeing more and more people coming in that are exposed to radiation, and it's ruining their cellular wall. People who are getting arthritis early and allergies early, and it's radiation. We're being poisoned, and our government is trying to cover it up. So I looked at the map beforehand, because with this software that's free, people can start their own consulting business. And we'll help them. We'll go on radio shows and stuff with them and say, oh, well, Gregg's the local person in this area. Get in touch with him, and he can do your vocal print. And we can save the planet.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got those three and the bonus software. It's allergies right now. But I think it's going to be changed out for, boy, I'm lying to you, eyes or something. But we have 71 softwares that we give away in rotation. So anybody can set up a consulting business with all of this free software. They need to buy a microphone, and that's, depending on where you buy it, anywhere from $15 to $25. And they can charge people $30 to $50 per report. It helps me because it helps me gather data. It helps the people doing it because their health is going to be better. It helps the people who are the bioacoustic practitioner because it's a way for them to make money for their families and their community.
Mm-hmm.
So that is our goal, to give away enough of this software that we can establish these bioacoustic communities everywhere. And people say, oh, well, if you're giving it away, it can't be any good. Well, it helps if people know we're a 501c3 nonprofit. And I also say to them, you know, when Oprah gave away those cars to her audience, nobody refused them. We wanted people to know that it's real stuff, that this isn't just a come-on class. This is real stuff that they can use. We used it in class. We taught people to use it while we were teaching them about it. And it's a tool and a solution for what's happening to our health. That's just atrocious and degrading, and I'm fed up with Obamacare, but that's another hour, somebody's health. I was just going to say, for them to ration insulin and medicine like they're doing right now for older folks, it's just atrocious. I hate it. And we can do the medications through sound. Insulin is one of the easiest ones that we found to do. So this is a new kind of medicine that's based on very ancient sounds and singing and feeling energy and laying out of hands. It's all the same stuff. It's all energy. We're just bringing it to the forefront and making it easy and available and accessible for everybody.
I feel like if they could do it, they would do Logan's Run here in a minute. They would, you know, except for themselves, they would kill off everybody else who is over 30. But I think we'll be able to manage to block this in some way. I'm sure that will be effective.
That's the thought behind all of this. But there's two other great big thoughts that I love. You know, they're calling us useless eaters and the planet's getting overpopulated and we got to get off. Well, we're starting to work with NASA until they lost most of their funding. We have found a sound that will keep the bones from deteriorating and keep the muscles from atrophying so that we can provide people these sounds in space travel, and that's one of the biggest detriments to a normal person traveling to another planet. We've solved that problem, so we don't have to be killed off because we're useless eaters.
Well, you know, I mean, I honestly don't think, you know, as much as they say we're overpopulated, I really just think it's because they've made such boundaries on this earth according to countries that there's so much open space that nobody lives in that people could live in if they weren't so possessive of their country's land and they could see this as a world issue rather than just, you know, a very small ethnocentric country issue. There's tons of land for people to live on and tons of ways to make food.
They're even upset about us breathing and putting carbon dioxide into the air. I mean, it's silliness. In New York, they tried to lay down a $50 fine for people growing tomato plants on their little porches and, you know, even up in the air. I don't know what you call those, a porch in the air. But a $50 fine for an inspector to come and see that you were growing the right kind of tomatoes and it wasn't taking up the carbon dioxide in the air. I mean, just crazy regulations to the point of it's more than obnoxious. I don't think I have a word that means stupid enough for what's going on here.
It's very tyrannical. It's just a tyranny is what it is. It's just a tyranny, and people have, you know, they've accepted that this is the way it is, so they don't see it as a tyranny because they just see this as normal. And And I think one of the really wonderful things of what you're offering is that, you know, so many people are just used to getting a Band-Aid for what's wrong with them. It's like, okay, you have high blood pressure, here, take a pill. You have pain, take a pill. And what you're doing is you're really going to the root of the issue of what's creating this, and you're saying, but this is why you have this. So you're going a step further that everybody truly, really needs and wants if they're willing to bypass that pill. You know, and God, I wish people could really hear your technology and get to know you. And I really hope this spreads because I think this is fantastic, amazing, amazing health breakthrough. I love you for your work and your dedication to this because I honestly think this is enormous. It has enormous potential. And I mean, I personally would love to volunteer in any way I could to help with it because I agree with you. I mean, I agree that they're absolutely trying to kill us off, and if we can get together as a group and find ways to heal each other and bypass their whole system, then we have a chance.
Well, it's putting it all in the hands of the people. When we first discovered that we could take this to the people in computers and all that, I went to a lawyer that I really love. Her name is Naomi R. Fine, and I love her name. She won a lot of cases for early computer programs or companies like Apple against IBM and all that. But she said, I've seen a lot of million-dollar ideas cross my desk, but this is a billion-dollar idea if you can keep it in the hands of the people, because whoever controls this technology controls the quality of life. And I think with few exceptions, people would like to control or have dominion over their quality of life. And I feel like that's what we're offering. You know, all these people had reasons why they couldn't take our courses. They couldn't afford it. They couldn't do this. They didn't know about computers. And in every case, we did a computer training class. We offered classes for free. We tried to make this so easy for people. Push a few buttons. What is it, 5 buttons that you push and you get a nano voice report, and you didn't have to do anything but speak to the computer for about 2 minutes. We made it easy. We made it accessible. We made it inexpensive. But there's sometimes when people still don't want it. That just blows my mind that they don't want to be in control. And so convincing people to be self-responsible, which is probably a lot of what you do. You tell people what's going on, hand them that information, and say, now what are you going to do about it? But it takes a long time, well, for me anyway, to convince people not to depend on me, but to depend on themselves and what their voice says about them. In looking at your voice, you have 2 tracks in your voice, Sherrie, and you have a lot of B notes, and that's a burgundy blue, and that means a love of humanity. Now, not necessarily one person at a time, but you love harmony and being able to tell people about themselves. You can provide the missing pieces and put them back together. That's kind of the same thing I'm trying to do.
Yay.
That's so amazing how you can just do that, listening to a person's voice, and automatically, without the software, obviously the software was made around your ability, but it's so amazing how you can just do that naturally, listening to someone.
I think everybody could do it if they just trusted themselves, because think about Sherrie's voice. It is this beautiful, deep blue with edges of cranberry. And so you know that that's the note of B because that's the related color. And people who have the note of B are in between worlds because it's in between one octave and another, B and C. And she's already told me that she's a medium, so a note of B was a good choice. But it was the sound of her voice. that gave the frequencies. And there's also a split, because she's using a different voice now than she did at the beginning of the show. Go listen to it. There was a little girl quality to her voice at the beginning, but go listen to it now. There's an authoritative piece to what's going on. And she is a helper who will help those who help themselves. Gregg, your voice is a D note, so you got some, it's sort of a orangish yellow. Guitar, liver, expression of words. Well, we did your voice in class, so you know what's going on. But if you knew everybody around you and knew how they thought, how to get along with them, what they had missing, what they had too much, what kind of food they needed, and you could be more compatible with them. Think about this is a strange situation. Teenagers who build up an intolerant amount of their parents' voice. They can't even stand to listen to the voice, much less listen to the words. That is a biological function to get them out of the house. They can't stand the parents. But our society crosses that up and says, you got to stay. See, Sherry's experienced this.
I think I haven't been away from my daughter. She's almost 22. I don't think I've been away from her for more than 2 days at a time her whole life. She's stuck like gum. She better like my voice because she's stuck.
Well, sometimes if one's left brain and one's right brain, they're kind of get some Velcro in between there. But for a lot of people, they have to experience this horrible leaving. And if we understood that they're being that way because that's a biological function and not blame them emotionally, I think it'd be a better world. Another one is women who go back to somebody who just beat the crap out of them. It's because that person has their missing note. But this explains why people like that kind of music and that color and that kind of furniture and that shape of a house, because it's all frequency from the beginning. Frequency is.
You know, folks, Sherry was mentioning how she's basically giving these programs away on her website. And for those listening, and anyone that knows me, I work 12 to 15 hours every day, 365 days a year, and I found the time to take one of Sherry's classes, and I'll be taking her class next week with Kendra. So if you can find the time to help humanity, I implore you that you look into it. And as a matter of fact, you were mentioning in an email, Sherry, that you have a special offer too.
Yes, the class is not full, so when this happens, and we've got two slots left, we offer matching scholarships to people, or we match, I don't even know what to call it. If two people want to take the class together as one unit, then we have them only pay one fee. But we'll help people earn their money. PayPal will loan people the money to take this class. We help people find sponsors in their community. We try every way possible to help them get in this class. But there's expenses to it, too. They get a tone box. They get headphones. They get a microphone. They get a $600 textbook that has to be done on special paper. I mean, there is so much to this class. They can go to our site, to soundhealthoptions.com, and just go to classes and read about this. And people can make their money back almost immediately with what's going on. But at the same time, I've got to pay the rent. And, you know, I feel like sometimes I need to apologize for charging money for these professional classes where we give away all of this stuff. But I can't ask my staff to work for free. And I think it's disgusting for people to ask for money just because they're down in the dumps and they're depressed and they don't work, so they want somebody else to pay them. That was not a good explanation. But I go on. I go on so many shows where the host asks for money and donations. And one particular host I know about, she took the donations and went on a trip to not Australia, Argentina. She took people's donations. I just find that despicable. And she said, well, people want to give me money. Well, I want to give them back something for their money. I want to give them back more than they paid. But that's me, and this is a difficult subject for me to even talk about in having to charge somebody for a class.
I think we're going to develop a great relationship together through your work in N5D and our viewership and our listeners, and we're going to get this word out to as many people as possible. I just want to see you succeed as much as you possibly can, because I know you're going to help humanity.
That's wonderful. The other thing that we need are trainers and teachers. So if there are people in each community that want to hold classes, we will help them do that. We will provide the software for them. And so not only by having clients can they support themselves, but by teaching these classes, they can help support themselves. The economy seems to be really rotten, especially for those on the bottom. There's just nothing left. Where you used to be able to afford hamburger, now you're eating cat food. And I read that in a book, so I just really stole it from somebody. That people are spending the same money on groceries, but instead of eating the steak, they're eating hamburger or even cat food. And they're trying to tell us that the economy is good, and I look at their vocal prints, and they're lying, and they know it, and they keep saying it. I think that's one of the biggest things that we have to offer that anybody can look at using the nano voice. They can look at Obama or Hillary or Harry Reid or Dinesh D'Souza, who just is releasing a movie about Obama's background, or Edward Snowden, or Bradley Manning. They can see who's really telling the truth and what the motivation is. And I think that's really important. If we can call our leaders on their garbage and say, this is what you're really thinking, don't try to convince me of that. And I'm going to get political here in a minute, and then I'll get off my soapbox about it. When we're looking at Obama and all these promises, and in the beginning, he really had good intentions. But he was also very manipulative at the same time. In the beginning, his voice sounded like Jimmy Carter. And then he changed it to Ron Paul. And the week that he changed his voice and his voice cadence to John F. Kennedy, that's the week that he surpassed Hillary. But his voice right now is so high in C sharp, which is my way or the highway. 42 is normal, and he's up into the 700s. He doesn't give a twit about the people. It's his own aggrandizement and his way or the highway. And you can see it in his voice, and I want to publish that.
Do you think that the people that are perhaps the people that are behind Obama or whatever, do they tell them to speak in a certain cadence specifically to play on our emotions?
Unfortunately, I've trained one of them.
Really?
Yes. I teach in the film department every quarter at the university, and I was asked to come and teach in the political science department, and somebody was in that class, and I didn't know it, and they were a campaign manager for a very high-up government official that's known worldwide. And I taught them, you know, how to be believable. And I quit teaching that, but it's out there. But if you can catch them unofficially, like on the street or in a spontaneous speech, you can look behind their words and see what's going on. Anybody interested in whose idea it was, that stupid film story about Benghazi?
Yeah.
That's all over the news. Whose idea was this? Well, Susan Rice was just taking dictation for people. It wasn't her idea. She was just out there being the puppet. it wasn't Obama's because he's over here with his ego and this is good for the country and I'm going to support it. It was Hillary's idea. And you can look at that. It's on our site. And it's the Benghazi truth. And it shows you the vocal prints. And we took their speeches apart sentence by sentence. We used Obama and Hillary. When the caskets were coming off the plane and they were standing there saying, it's this awful video. And they knew. And now it's proven. We published it months ago. Now it's proven by all of the evidence that they were lying and they knew all along. We said Dinesh D'Souza was going to be found guilty of this campaign fraud. He was. We said Jerry Sandusky, I don't know if that's too old for you guys to remember.
No.
The guy that was molesting the little kids, Penn State, we said he'll be found guilty. And this is the word that his guilt is based on. And it was horseplay. And we published that Chris Christie is not guilty. You know, and we put those on our website for people to know who they should believe and who they should follow and who they should kick in the behind and get them out of office. But they've all lied through since we've been doing this. We started with the 08. Well, we started before that because we started with Clinton. And we did McCain and all those 08 people. We did the 2012 people. And you could tell who was serious. You could tell who was going to win. Do you want to know who's going to win by their vocal print if they run?
Of course.
I don't like the idea, but it's Jeb Bush.
Bush. You mentioned that in class.
He has.
Oh, no.
I know.
He has the most believable voice of any of them.
That's horrible.
And people are going to feel that. With Clinton, he had the note of D completely missing, and D was for other people. And for people who are wondering what I'm talking about, this little nano voice takes all of your voice print and puts it in little note C, C sharp, D, D sharp, in little categories, and then gives you a printout. And when D is missing, then you're not helpful to other people. And that's what Bill Clinton had missing when he was running for office. And that's what they pushed on his soundboard, or at least that's what they were taught to push on their soundboard. If somebody has this missing, this is what you can, like an equalizer on your stereo, you can move some sounds up and down to please yourself. And the note of D missing is what made women think that he had a little boy quality. And so he got a lot of the older women's vote. I just think it's incredible how you can manipulate people with voice. The more balanced your voice, the more believable you are. And Bush's voice is incredibly balanced and full. I've not heard him speak a lot, but of all the candidates out there at this point, he's the best voice. Now, is he the best candidate? I don't know, but he's the best voice.
Now, in class, I was curious about how the comparison would be between Ron Paul and his son, one being a conservative and one being a libertarian. So it'd be interesting if you could actually get that done at some point and do that comparison to see how they match up and who's really the better of the two people.
Ron Paul lost his heart when they came after him. He lost his heart to fight. Here's Ron Paul on Ram and Santorum. I have that. Ron Paul has this love of humanity where Ram is more willing to play the game.
Yeah. That makes sense.
Well, I have several here on our site on Rand Paul. This one is gave the victory speech after winning Senate Republican primary election in Bowling Green, Kentucky. And he has that same love of humanity and helping people, and that note of D that his dad does, but his dad's note is emotional, where his is mental. So this is just the printout. I could read you some of it if you want to know what he was feeling at the time, and so people can get an idea of what comes out of these printouts.
Sure.
Rand Paul's voice portrays him as a left-brain thinker, not a doer, not a feeler. The notes in C and B are nicely balanced, meaning he has intentions of humanity at heart. He wants to help people and do what's right, but he's also obvious that his entire platform is not his own. He will leave the overall actions to someone else, but will stand strong on his own intellect to put others first. There's a bit of arrogance here and a bit of scattered potential starting at F sharp, which indicates a lack of being able to carry out a plan. He is sincere with strong motivations to be fair, but also a strong believer in making people do their own work. His weakness is a lack of right-brained thinking. The ducks need to be in a row before he will act. Not very good at spontaneous reactions, but knows what's right. He needs experience of himself and others as his guide before he moves forward. Now, if people knew that about a candidate, wouldn't they have a different idea from just the words and what they're going to do or what they're not going to do?
I'm sorry. I think it's wonderful information to know, you know, beforehand. I also think that, you know, from what you've described of him, that he could have a nice entourage that could supplement that other side of the brain thinking. He could have people really that could be wonderful to help where he's not quite there versus someone who's really not a humanitarian at all and definitely their heart's not in the right place. I'd rather see someone who's a little bit, you know, not perfect, but that can have a great support staff, you know?
Absolutely. Teamed up with somebody who had that go take charge kind of idea. But whoever goes up against Hillary, they're going to undermine him to the nth degree. She is going to run, by the way, as her health allows. And that's her concern at the moment. The other is if she can manage all of these stories that are coming out. And Fox News, I don't know if people hate Fox News or not. Some people do. But they are bringing out some of the information, some in a good, clear way, some in a very pushy my way kind of thing. But Greta Van Susteren is one of the ones that's very fair, and I don't know if it's because she was an attorney or what, but she presents the evidence and tells it like it is. And Judge Jean will tell you like it is, too. She told off Obama the other day.
She did.
Another one that's not going to make it is Ben Carson. He's the one that stood up at the breakfast meeting and told off Obama. It was a prayer breakfast meeting, and he was talking about how we have this image of a bald eagle, and it's not bald because it's no hair or no feathers. It's piebald, meaning white. And he said, that's the symbol of our country. And for it to fly and soar, it has a left wing, it has a right wing, and they must move together and be in synchronicity. And that's not what's happening in this country. And everybody stood up and applauded, and even Obama applauded. But the White House then demanded an apology from Ben Carson. And now Ben Carson has a book out about the government and what's really wrong with it, and he is a neurosurgeon, I believe. I know he's an MD. But he doesn't have enough strength in his voice to get the candidacy. Who would you really like to see get it?
Me.
Yeah.
Because I would help humanity. I'd like to see you, actually. Let's vote for Sherry Edwards. How about that?
No way. Who in their right mind would start a job with half the people hating them?
But you have half the people loving you.
I can't see why anybody would want to be a politician. Oh, I think the only worst job would be having to stick people with needles.
See, my belief is that we should have a council of elders, and we can vote on them every month, and the minute that they stop working in humanity's best interest, they're fired. They're completely transparent. They represent each race of ethnicity on this planet, and they have to show what they're doing in a positive way for humanity. That's the way to do it. Get rid of government.
How can we get that going?
Get rid of government.
we just had a premiere of a new movie that I was featured in called The Business of Disease, and it's about how we need to change, and the champions need to be for health, not for the business or the money in their pocket. And I went as Yoda, and that council with Yoda and the Jedis, and but even they had some bad guys. But I think the idea of Yoda doing it for humanity, what is the blue book that it's Zen, and Course in Miracles. I think that is an incredible sentiment. I love it. And if the whole earth could do it, that would be wonderful. But there's always going to be some of the guys out there who put your money in their pocket and don't think a thing about it. Have you read Animal Farm?
A long time ago. Oh, my God. I think that was I had to read that in eighth grade. Sherry?
Yes.
Oh, no, it's required reading.
Yeah.
And it's about these farmers that were taking advantage of the chickens, taking their eggs and not giving them enough food, taking the milk from the cow. So they ran the farmer out, and they decided to rule as a group, just like you're suggesting. And it came to pass that people were giving up their responsibility because somebody else would take it. And the pigs came into power. And the pigs start treating all the rest of the animals in the same way because the animals gave up their power for rest and relaxation and not having to think. And here we go again with the same idea of why I create software and give it away. Self-responsibility. How do we keep up that notion that it comes from inside? Not a lot of people even want to look at that. That's some employees. And I run my business as a participatory management. Everybody gets a say. And I had a guy who said, just tell us what you want us to do and just shut up about it. We don't care what goes. We're here for a paycheck. And it's like, you can't stay here with that attitude. But he was really serious. He wanted his paycheck and wanted me to shut up. And a lot of people are that way. How do we change them? How do we put that spirit, that even, I want to say policeman, but that's not the quite word. How do we put that inside so that they monitor themselves? You know, we've had employees that say, oh, Sherry's not coming in today. She's writing. We don't have to do anything. You know, that's theft. And people, for some reason, really think that way. How can we empower them to be the best that they can be? Sherry, what do you tell people when they're stuck in that place?
I mean, I think that part of who I am is a cheerleader. And I try my best of when I see people who are not in the spot B or they're not realizing their preciousness, I try to find it. I mean, usually it's obvious to me. I can always find something wonderful about someone. It's real easy. And so I try to push that. And I really do, because I think if people can see the good things in themselves and they can appreciate their preciousness, then they'll be better. They'll do better things. They'll be better people. I think sometimes they just, you know, they'll get stuck on one thing they do wrong or a bad decision, and then instantly they're a bad person, and it's just simply not true. So I try to be the cheerleader. I try to just find something great about somebody and say, but you remember when you did this? And you're awesome. You know, so that's my deal.
Well, it's all those oughts and shoulds and commercials and teachers that really don't know how to empower a student because they don't have enough time, that just get us into a rut till people don't even know who they are. Have you heard of the movie The Secret?
I love it.
Well, it tells you that by your thoughts, by your own self-power, you can have whatever you want, be whatever you want. But they forgot one little notion. What if it's your neighbor's wife that you want? Who gets to say at that point? So I think there's places where people really don't know what they want because of all of these overlays, and I've just had some run-ins with some teachers not treating children well. I don't want to say this, but I have to. I detest a bully, and I shouldn't detest anybody. That means I got a lesson to learn. But I detest bullies or people who take advantage of someone else. And that's one of the things that the nano voice tells you. You can talk to it. Well, I had this run-in today, and this is what happened. And it'll tell you how it made you feel bad, and it'll tell you how to deal with the other person. And it brings back that power in people from all the spin and garbage and marketing and teaching. You know, they left out these ideas of know yourself. Well, how long has it been since you went to school? Did they really pay attention to things like courage and responsibility and intention, or did they teach you to a test? You have to pass this test.
It's pretty much all left brain thinking in school. They rarely encourage creativity and thinking outside the box.
They don't have time, for one thing. But there's things that Obama, and this is a one of those signed the executive orders, he has put even home schools under his jurisdiction and is trying to dictate what should be taught in that school. And that's where it begins, with us teaching our children how to be real and authentic. You know, a real example, why is your coat in the floor? You know, and you're grouching and being a parent. But if you say, is there a reason your coat's in the floor? And if they have a good enough reason, they can leave their coat in the floor. They'll pay the cleaning bill. But just giving them choice. And I guess I don't think there's ever going to be any change in our government or anything else into a committee unless somebody has choice and options. And they can't. If we're constantly being poisoned with bad air, bad food, bad water, bad government, you know, you look at Maslow's hierarchy of needs, and at the bottom it's safety and health. And people, I don't feel safe. Do you? I mean, with drones and domestic terrorists, and they can arrest you if you disagree with the government, and the things that they are doing are designed to make people feel unsafe. And I just said the word they. Who is they? Big government, big pharma, PHARMA, big pharma, FARMA, the people with the purse strings that are buying those people at the top so they can control the rest of the people. And back to Animal Farm, we're here working and giving our eggs and our milk and more and more and more of it to the government, so they can do whatever they want to it and give it to whoever they want to. I want to stop that. And I think with self-responsibility, now I'm on my soapbox here, bad. With that, with opening people up and thinking, people will stop. You know, right now in my company, I pay 64% of our income in taxes. It's killing us. But I will not stop, because I believe we're a fence between those who want to control and those who want to be cooperative.
Why and how is the government, big pharma, and the medical industry allowing you to do this program?
Because I have done some work for them, and I have a breakthrough about how to distort time with frequency, and they want it, and working with, well, I decoded ricin. I helped with the Jerry Sandusky case. They want me to create a program about truthfulness and who's telling the truth and who isn't, and provide it to them. They like the talent that I have, and I went right to their door. And I said, look what I've got. Look what I can do. And they said, go away. This is not medical. Go away. But they still came back and asked me to do things. Mm-hmm. And I don't really know why they're letting me live.
Wow. So what is stopping any given big pharma corporation from copying your material, then patenting it under a different name, and then ultimately suppressing this idea from the public?
Well, they've already done that, some already. When they're looking at ultrasounds to make bones heal, it, when you examine it, that looks like our stuff. But you go back a step and say, okay, a sound that'll make a bone heal, no matter who's inventing it, here it is. So there's a lot of that going on, but we keep our stuff as trade secrets, and everybody has to sign a contract. So they really can't go out and do a lot with it. And every time they take something, I got 20 things on the shelf that I can bring out, and we're out ahead again, dancing at how far behind they are. Pfizer Pharmaceuticals did something in 2004, and we had turned it into the National Institute of Health. And there they are using the stuff we turned in. I wasn't dumb enough to give them all of it. But I couldn't fight Pfizer Pharmaceuticals, so I just did a big press release and said, I'm very happy they are following in our footsteps. The other big piece of this is a Guardian program. We have an underground program, and it's on our site under Guardian, that people can become a member of that, and it's $40 a month. They get a software program, 2 hours of class, tutoring sessions. There's a whole tutoring group. And we are releasing this software for them to use so that if anything happens, we have all of these people in place, whether it's a plague or the flu or radiation. And that's really where our power is coming from that group. And there's less than 1,000 in that group right now. But if something happens to me, number one, I'll just go haunting from the other side and help more and know more. But the other side is there's enough people to take this forward, so mm-hmm. they'll not kill it. I wanted to make that really clear before we took it to the public. I knew what I could do. I knew I could hear these sounds and do them. And so I went on tour, and this was in the early 80s, and I thought it would take me about 10 years. And I went on tour, and I thought, when somebody tells me about me, then I'll know that I have the 100th monkey. I'll know that enough people know this that I can go home. And I left my 3 little kids and my husband, and I went on tour in this great big 32-foot bus around the country. And I was doing a show in Georgia with the Sufi group and teaching them how to do it. And they were out in the field dancing. And there were some little kids there, and mosquitoes were eating them up. So I took the kids back to the house, and it was getting dusk. And I was teaching them how to do their own sounds and hear other people's sounds. And I think that's where you ought to start with the kids. And it was just dusk, and this guy came out of the house through these French doors. And I really couldn't see him. I, you know, I could see that it was a person. And he came over and kind of sat on the chair across from me. And he said, well, I heard you doing these sounds, and I want to tell you about this woman who does things that you're doing. She makes sounds like this, and she does healing with sound, and she does research with sound. And, boy, my ears perked up, and I said, I have to meet her. You know, who is it? And remember, I didn't know this guy. He said, it's Sherrie Edwards. And I was like, oh, thank you, God. I can go mm-hmm. home now. And that ended up being about 1987 or 8. And from there, we did a lot more of the research, published more papers, was able to control blood pressure, and we opened our doors to the public in 1991. Totally stupid, ignorant, oblivious, but I had enough information to know that it was possible. So we started teaching classes in 1991, and there's thousands of people now, everybody from physicists to belly dancers to real estate agents, people from all continents. We just had a big conference here, and people from several continents that were part of the conference. So the word is spreading, and just with people like you and your audience, we're spreading all over the world. And people can go look at the classes, free classes. There's free videos if people want to go to downloads and look at Secret Stash. There's two videos there, one called Breaking the Sound Barriers of Disease, which I think is what we're doing, and another one called Miracles of Non-Medicine, which is all the doctors, not all of them, a lot of the doctors that work with us, and what we can do, and how to take somebody's leg that was mangled and how to put it back together with sound, and how to take somebody who had MS and help them walk again and get rid of the pain meds. And it shows those miracles of non-medicine, reversing Down syndrome, reversing macular degeneration, helping people who've had stroke walk and talk again. This is the medicine of the future, but I also think it's the medicine of the past. I think this is something we forgot. And there's so much on our site. People could read about it. They could start their own business. We'd never know about it, but we're asking people give us back data so we can have a core pot of data. So all of a sudden we see 30 people in this little town has this kind of flu or this kind of toxin. It's going to be an early warning system if we all pool our information. That's kind of where we're going. And there needs to be a lot of leaders. And I'm doing this out of laziness. You know, I want this to happen, but I just can't get it all done. And if I can convince other people to do it, then I get a little rest. So we're just trying to spread the information everywhere. I have a lot of friends who think that, that I'm not really from this planet because of the talents, because of my ears, because of what I can do, because of what I think, what I bring in. But I'm an ordinary, frumpy little housewife from southern Appalachia, poverty-stricken Ohio. And if I can create this because I had a talent or I had a dream or I had an ambition, if I can do this from nothing, and it's been from nothing, then I think I want to help everybody realize what their talent is. Think about the United States map, and I'm in Ohio, and there was somebody over in Washington who tried to come and steal what we did, and we won in court and all that. But anyway, if he's over here trying to do what I'm doing, then Ohio looks very lumpy, and he left his state of Washington over there empty. Everybody has a talent, just like Sherry was saying, a talent, a specialty, a goodness. And if we can convince people what their talent is and have faith in themselves and quit fighting and quit being greedy, just think of all of that energy we would have to do the things to elevate mankind and our planet and the future. So I have these little teeny ideas of, oh, I'm too lazy to get it all done, to these grandiose ideas of going to different planets, and everything in between can be addressed with this idea of energy, because energy is, in the beginning, energy is. If you take the frequency of water and subtract the frequency of carbon, it equals like the frequency of sulfur. I don't know if I have those charts up. Let me see if I can find them. But if you have two waves of energy in a pool, you can see them mix and mingle. And that's how the beginning was, when there was only frequencies. And the frequencies, if we take the frequency of water plus the frequency of nitrogen, it equals oxygen. The frequency of carbon minus the frequency of hydrogen equals vitamin C. And you can watch these frequencies move together like ripples in a pond, and you can see how the universe was created. You can look at a tonoscope and put a frequency on, like, the head of a drum and cause a frequency on the drum head, and it will create a pattern. From the sound, it created a pattern. From the sound, it created matter. From the sound. So we're helping people go back to their original sound. And my soapbox again, the government is causing us not to be able to go back. You know, I don't know if it's the government. I'm going to talk about Gardasil for a minute. Vaccinations, which I think is an absolute scourge on the planet and our DNA, and is keeping us in a state of distress and not allowing us to go back to our core, our center, our sensitivity, our place of unconditional loving for humanity. And, you know, all of what I'm talking about here is how to live in man's world as opposed to how to live in God's world. Well, here's a piece from Man's World. Gardasil is a series of injections, vaccinations, provided to youngsters. And I just picked up a Reader's Digest, and they want 9-year-old boys to have this Gardasil shot, which is for cervical warts. Now, a cervix is the head of the uterus. 9-year-old boys don't even have a uterus, but they're insisting now, even beyond Diane Harper's information. I don't know if you know who Diane Harper is, but she was the original lead researcher for Gardasil. And I'll quote here. She says that 70% of all HPV, human papilloma, which is Gardasil supposed to cure, infections resolve themselves within a year, and within 2 years that percentage climbs to 90%. Dr. Harper also states that Gardasil would do little to prevent cancer, and she does not recommend Gardasil or Cervarix, a similar vaccine, to anyone younger than 15. Now, they want 12-year-old girls, it's a law in California, and 9-year-old boys. And they're also, in North Carolina, willing to give these kids an iPod if they'll take these shots and not tell their parents. Or they don't have to tell their parents. Now, I looked at, we decoded these vaccinations. I'm going to ask you the question, what you think it means when I'm done here. There's HPV-1. I should preface this with, everything has a frequency, just like the planets and all that. But everything has a biochemical frequency and a muscular frequency and a toxin frequency. So if somebody can't open a jar and their thumb is weak, if we give them the frequency of that muscle, they can open the jar. But if we give them a zinc tablet under their tongue, it strengthens that muscle, and they can open the jar. So everything has a frequency, and that's what we've decoded. So HPV-1 is the same frequency as the parathyroid hormone, which regulates calcium for ovulation and fertility. HPV-11 is progesterone, the hormone that maintains pregnancy. HPV-16 is NADPH, which is associated with the levels of male infertility, and calcitonin, which regulates calcium needed for ovulation and fertility. HPV-18 is the same frequency as estrogen and testosterone. Now, there is an article that came out that said the people who are putting these shots out are deliberately targeting inner-city poor and rural populations. And I think they think both of those populations are stupid and uneducated, because when it came to our town, people didn't know, and we helped them make decisions. But this is the same frequency that would cause infertility. Now, how can 4 shots, all with different frequencies, all be about infertility for males and females? What is Gardasil vaccine really?
I think that a lot of people are onto the Gardasil thing at this point. I rarely find anything in favor of it whatsoever, but especially what you're saying about the infertility, I mean, that's starting to be the view of quite a few sites that I see, that they're universally agreeing with that. And just, you know, one thing that I wanted to ask you, Sherrie, is that I wish that you would be so kind to explain. I know that you know, how you do this work is that you take somebody's vocal print, you see what's going on, you know, and you give them back their frequency to relieve their disease. How exactly do you do this start to finish?
Very good question. Let me make one more statement about Gardasil. I think they did this deliberately to create infertility. And we have created frequencies that are anti-Gardasil, so that if people are having trouble with fertility, we can help. That's the kind of thing that we do. So people can either come to see us at our clinic, or they can do this online. We do it free for people every Tuesday from 6 to 7, well, it's every other Tuesday, from 6 to 7. They can go to our site and go to Happy Hour, and there's a link there, and they can watch this done right on the air. And we do interpretations, and then we send them their reports. Anywhere from 10 to 15 reports that come out, along with instructions on how to do it. But essentially, we get them in front of a microphone. We ask them to take a sample or give us a sample of their voice and talk about whatever. And then we munch it on our computer, and the computer spits out the information. And we had a guy in, and they said, the doctor said he had MS. And he didn't really. He didn't match the MS profile. He matched a spine injury profile. And so we said to him, we don't think you have MS. That's why as they're treating it, it's not getting any better because it's not really MS. This is what we think. And he said, nah, nothing like that happened. 2 days later, he came back and he said, yeah, I remember a skiing accident. That really did happen. This was an MD, and they told him to go home and die because there was nothing more they could do for him. We were able to help him regrow his nerves from his waist down. Took 5 months from like November to May of the next year. But that's an impossible situation. You can't do that. So not only is this the frequencies that he needed, we gave him back in a little tone box, sort of like a low frequency. See if I can do it. And it entrains the brain. The brain is your central processing unit, and it sends off all these signals. And somehow his signals weren't getting where they ought to go. We gave them to him artificially, and he was able to regrow his nerves and walk again and get out of his scooter wheelchair thing and walk and go back to being a doctor again. That's the awesome part of that. And it only takes a 30-second vocal print. Another thing it does is diagnostic. Had a guy in that was in a car accident, and the airbag exploded in his face, and it hurt his little finger till he couldn't use it. And he came in, and he couldn't turn around or something. I can't remember. His leg was hurt. And he couldn't use his little finger. And in about 20 minutes, and this is on film at YouTube and Vimeo both and on our site, you can watch this happen. You can hear him talk on these free videos. In about 20 minutes, his hand was working well. He could turn. But the computer says, you know, there is a problem here. There is a biomarker for heart trauma. The muscle's been damaged. It was troponin. The computer caught it. But the doctors didn't. He went back to the doctor, and sure enough, there was damage to the heart. So this number system, and it's a real easy number system. Think about a grid, and across the top, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. You double it 100 times, and down the vertical side, 1, 1.01, 1.02, until you get to the complete number of 2 again. Think about all those numbers and all that grid. Every disease has a pattern on that grid, and we just figured it out. And if your brain doesn't have that grid in completeness, you go into disease. There was a great article in National Geographic where they mapped the brain, and they said the brain is laid out in grid patterns, much like a Rubik's Cube. And every little grid has a frequency that matches, monitors, and controls, and has all these harmonics. Now, they just published that article, I think it was in February of this year, and we've known that for over 20 years, that we could control different parts of the brain by giving you specific frequencies in a specific formulation. And we could cause your body, now I shouldn't say it that way, we could cause your body, that's not right. We could encourage your body to heal itself. And I think we have this self-healing body all along. You've probably seen or heard of spontaneous remissions. It came from the brain. And there's even articles about the nocebo effect, placebo, people healing themselves even though they weren't given the right medication. I think we're just now beginning to tap in to that part of the brain. And I think our mouth, our words, are a way to find out what's going on in the brain, the frequencies of your words. I think we could do it from eyelashes if we could figure out the code. But we have this dual situation of in your ear, out your mouth, in sound, out sound. There's no other system in the body like that. But I think from the frequencies of your words, we can look at your brain. And we could look at what's not there. And that's what our work is about. We can look at the frequencies that are missing or too plentiful, and we can see what's wrong with you. Just like Gregg's back. It showed the muscles that were in stress. And it showed, didn't we do an allergy one on you too, Gregg?
I think you wanted to, but you couldn't find the following day. You couldn't find the correct chart, so you used somebody else's.
Oh, we couldn't find your chart. Okay.
Yeah.
When people take the class, we ask them to sit in front of a microphone and send us a vocal print, and we can run it through our machine, and this and this and this and this and this is an issue. Cancer, you know, people are afraid of cancer. We have a computer program called Cancer Absolute, and there are three things that we primarily look at because they're consistent with every cancer. Calcitonin that controls calcium gets unbalanced. Catalase, which is that juicy stuff in cucumber and apples, good apples that haven't been GMO'd. Catalase goes really low, and that's an enzyme that cleans your blood. And a frequency for vitamin A goes very high and is not usable. You can tell when somebody's going to have cancer years before it ever happens. And then we start looking at cancer food, arachidonic acid and hydrogen peroxide. Those two mix in the body and create something called 5-HETE for cancer food. Now, how valuable is it that we could look at cancer years before it ever manifested, take away its food, and it would die off? How valuable
wow.
is that?
I had a stage 3 melanoma on my back. That would have been incredibly invaluable instead of having this 8-inch gash on the side of my back.
Well, calcitonin is the major issue because when the body wants to be healed, the cells send out a little signal, and you know, help, help, and it's frequency, and it calls calcium to the site, and calcium acts as the foreman to make everything better, and it okay, we need some of this and some of this and some of this. And without calcium, the body can't heal itself. So there's a trauma. It calls out for calcium. And this cancer food, 5-HETE, although made up of something totally different, as its bottom line, it's almost the same frequency as calcium within 1/100th. So if the calcium isn't there and readily available, then the cancer food gets caused to the trauma site, and there's where the problem starts. Calcitonin, you can buy it in pill form. It's salmon, but it's a little different from human. But we can also help people with frequency when we find it's a C sharp. When we find out that that is an issue, it's an early warning system. Here's another one that we just did. Do you have time for another story?
Sure.
I think that the VA, and we've been doing this for 2 years now, is really mistreating returning veterans. And we have this whole phantom limb project that we're doing. But the Army asked us to do a study on traumatic brain injury, and they gave us a vocal prints of 30-some people. And we were able to show the proteins in the brain that proved that there was damage, and there was 9 consistent proteins. On top of that, I started looking at it, and you know these guys are PTSD. I mean, they've got traumatic brain injury. We found 8 consistent nutrients with these people with PTSD, and that's another program we gave away. So the first 4 are calcium, niacin, linoleic acid, and zinc. Calcium, niacin, linoleic acid, and zinc. These are the people that have PTSD, but they don't realize that they are ill. They're schizophrenic. They're not in touch. The next level is progesterone, B5, choline, and magnesium. Now, those are the ones committing suicide. So those nutrients are really important for those folks. And we can look at the vaccinations that were given 10 and 20 at a time to these soldiers and look at the interference patterns in those nutrients. You wonder why there's so many soldiers coming back now with depression and they're killing themselves hourly. You can trace it back bioacoustically to the vaccinations. How ugly is that?
How do you find the frequency for, you know, you say you have the healing frequencies for something like calcium. Is there a healing frequency? How do you find the healing frequency for calcium? I mean, does calcium have a certain frequency? And if it does, how do you find that? Or do you just give the supplement?
You can do either. But how this happened in the beginning is I can touch a person and feel the frequency for the muscle. And then we give them the frequency for the muscle to make it weak or strong. But we weren't really sure about biochemicals till one day we were in the office giving somebody a sound, and one of the workers came in. They said, I don't know what you're doing here, but I'm having a niacin flush. And, that's a good one. That frequency causes a niacin flush. Then we started to use some spray vitamins, and we'd test people, we'd spray the vitamin in their mouth, and monitor what frequencies rose or spiked. Okay, that's B12. Then we did it with sublingual vitamin C, and we saw what rose. Then we started doing it with toxins, like we did a project for Diet Pepsi, and we could look at aspartame and see how that was going to affect everybody. Now, not everybody was affected by it, but those that were, it was pretty outrageous.
So the voice frequencies are from your own voice that are then databased. Are these from yourself?
No, from the people that we did these experiments on.
For the healing ones.
For the healing ones, well, we just looked at what was in the voice and we gave them back. And we saw how their body responded, and we hook them up to biofeedback equipment and get their body to respond and then test their voice again and see if their voice is in balance.
Okay, I understand. So it's not necessarily that you're, you know, giving somebody something to listen to that's of a frequency that's healing them. You're actually, you know, diagnosing what they're missing or what's damaged, and you're giving them some type of nutritional element or so you're testing things on them to see the positive, negative, emotional, physiological frequency of it, but you're not actually having them listen to something versus like sound healing.
That's one of the choices, to have them listen to something, either music or have them tone their own sounds, have them play an instrument, have them go into a room where the sound of the room, like a round room, will make a note of C, give them the nutrition, send them to the chiropractor, send them to the Lyme's disease, we'll send them to the doctor for doxycycline. If they don't want to take it by sound, the doctor can give it to them. So we give people many, many options.
If I could just jump in real quick, we never had a chance to talk about this in class. What would be the note for the sciatica? Because I play guitar. I could find that note easily.
D-sharp.
Wow.
It's
wonderful.
D-sharp, about 10% sharp. But for people in a coma or people who are already sick, they they can't sing the sounds, or babies, or kids. So we do it. You can do it with color. You can do it with sound. You can do it with touch. Like we did Reiki people before and after. And before, the two people were different. But once the Reiki person did their thing, then the two people's vocal prints were almost identical.
Oh, that's cool.
I mean, I'll give you an example of something that happens in the body. Aspartame, we just talked about it. And let's say aspartame is a 10. And let's say there's something in the body called glutamate, and it's a natural substance. It's a 10. But the aspartame is made of 9 and 1, an unbalanced 10. And the glutamate is made of 5 and 5, a very balanced 10. So you drink a bunch of diet Pepsi or eat something with a lot of aspartame in it, and your muscles call for something to repair them, and it keeps the muscles supple and no cramps and keeps the muscles clean, and you haven't eaten anything with this glutamate. So aspartame goes to the site, and aspartame binds with the cells, and then you get stiff muscles, and the muscles are full of trash, and you get fibromyalgia. And so unnatural things in the body that emulate patterns of something that is natural is an issue. Marijuana and progesterone are the same frequency, and they have some of the same side effects, the munchies, and some of the same healing effects. So do you want to take the sound? Do you want to take the progesterone? Do you want to take the marijuana? Which would you like? It's up to the person how they want to be healed.
The frequencies are all within a big math matrix, basically.
Absolutely.
Wow.
You are really a very sophisticated robot. Everything that happens in your body happens based on math of positive and negative potential, of tension and release in the muscles, or how things flow through the body. And we just broke the codes.
Now, I know a lot of our N5D listeners would like to know, can your software be used to analyze metaphysical abilities such as telepathy or ESP or even past life experiences?
Yes. Your own A-sharp. Now, back to the astrology that we talked about a little bit. As the planets move, they make a sound, a frequency. That frequency comes to the earth. It controls the tides and the waters. It controls us. So here's the frequencies of the astrology that comes to the planet, and that influences you totally. When you can look at your base frequency, well, it's all in a pattern, and it's in a pattern much like astrology is where I was going. And you can look at what you're worrying about in the future and what you've seen in the past. And your own A-sharp, which is in a mathematical pattern around the 365 days of the year, your own A-sharp will allow you to go into altered states. We can look at your pattern from the day you were born to now and see what it is. If, as long as we know your birthday, we can look up your patterns of what will happen. And in Sherry's case, I will bet that when she does her mediumship, her vocal print will split into several octaves. And when somebody has that layered effect, then they can deal with people on many different octaves. We look at six octaves, and we found a man, he was head of an ashram out in California, and he was aware, awake on five different octaves. So he was very comfortable talking to the trash man and to God at the same time. So it's your level of awareness and where you are. And yes, we can look at that, and we can see where your energy is when you talk about it. But you have a base frequency, and then there's all these patterns that go with it. I forget when you said your birthday was, Gregg.
October 19th.
So you're an F-sharp, you're a Libra?
I am a Libra.
So F-sharp, C, B. Your stuff from the past is going to be all about the note of B, peace and harmony, being the person that brings people together with the information that calms the waters, a love of humanity, a soul searcher, somebody that brings the patterns of oversouls to other people, that's your past.
Wow. the people that are listening that know me, they're saying, there you go, you nailed it. And you are so right. I mean, this is my life mission. Everything you said is exactly how I feel.
Well, it's all in the patterns, and I think this is an ancient mystery, is from the Templars, from the beginning. And all I'm doing is bringing it into modern computerization to make it easy for people. But there's about 10% of the people out there who are intuitive and sensitive, and they can tell you those things. But there's about 40% of people who just want to deal with the facts, and about 40% of people who just want to deal with the how-to and the lay of the land, and 10% of people who want to deal with the future and the sociology. So here we are, this 10% of intuitive people, and we're going against 90% of the other guys. And we want to bring this because it's so blissful and so peaceful. But they can't understand it. The computer program just brings it to them.
Well, I'll jump in and have a question, and it's on what you were talking about on the psychic ability. Is I did read that you said there was an article when psychic isn't psychic anymore that actually said, well, it's not unknown because we know what causes it, and that you had mentioned that you noticed that psychic people had very high levels of norepinephrine. And I was just wondering, I'm so sorry to destroy the word. And so what does that actually have to do with psychic ability, and why do they have high levels, and is there a way to adjust it upward or downward?
Well, it is an F sound, and it comes through GABA and dopamine and then norepinephrine. It controls weight, which is one of the issues why psychics have problems with glucose and blood sugar, because as they become more sensitive to other people and become the frequency of someone else, their blood sugar becomes very narrow, like 80 to 120 is normal, and it may be 96 to 102 for someone who is very, very sensitive, as their body begins to take on other people's frequencies. Like when I do someone's sound, and this is published in our stuff, our brains synchronize to 3 decimal points. We might as well be the same person. But the sounds that I do are sine waves, and humans can't do sine waves, they say, but, you know, here I am. So when I do a sound for someone, like I hear your sound right now, our brains will entrain. And when our brains become one brain by their frequency, then we know each other's patterns and thoughts. And I think that's where psychic ability comes from. Just like laying on of hands healing, the brain patterns, the vocal print, becomes the same. And I think that's where psychic ability comes from. I can't prove it. I can't prove it either that there's, well, I can prove there's a sound coming out of your ear, but I think as you speak, those sound waves interrupt the sound that's coming out of my ear, and that's what creates the meaning. But you must in tune to people through their frequencies or touching something or whatever is going on. You become their frequency, and then that's how you know. But doing that causes your body to be very sensitive. We've written an article about that. We studied about 6,000 people over 10 years. But it explains why a lot of psychics and intuitives have issues with their health and their immune system, because they're all the time becoming somebody else.
Well, definitely, when you become sensitive to everything around you, when you become, you know, super sensitive or ultra sensitive, you know, I've just found that I'm pretty much allergic or sensitive to almost everything at this point. I drink one sip of red wine and I'm practically drunk. I mean, it's ridiculous. So a real cheap date there. But that's just part of, you know, being ultra sensitive is you just, in order to be able to pick up people's, you know, free vibrations, you mm-hmm. actually become sensitive to the vibrations of even everything, even things that you shouldn't.
Well, going back to center on who you are, and that's one of the things that some intuitives have trouble with, letting go of that other person and coming back. When I deal with a person, even in the lab, here's an example. I go into the lab, and the person's already there. It was a Japanese guy, and the whole room was dirty yellow. And I thought, oh, I'm hallucinating. And I did his frequency, and at that point, we didn't want anybody to tell us what was going on because we were doing raw tests. And I said, it's glaucoma. It's cataracts. You have cataracts. And I said, what's it like to have a cataract? And he said, well, everything, the air looks kind of dirty. And I said, well, the answer to it's germanium. And he pulled a vial of germanium out of his pocket. And Japan had sent him to us to offer to buy the company. But I had automatically, as I walked in the room, became his frequency. And this is the, I don't know if it's a cheat or a trick, but I automatically go into other people's energy, and then I can tell how they're responding and tell what's going on with them. But I don't like a lot of people to know that, because then I get absolutely bombarded. But we can do things from a photograph for animals or people in comas. We try not to do a lot of that because we can't do it very scientifically. But in looking at anybody's energy pattern, you begin to change, if you're any good, as an intuitive or a psychic, and you become their pattern. To let go is not an easy thing. I'm a water sign, and so I drink water or just flick water on me, and that sort of takes me back to my my energy pattern. But I stayed sick for a long time because I was this person and that person and that person, and I had everybody's disease. So letting go and using your own birthday sound for it. Like, when's your birthday?
My birthday's April 12th.
So you're a note of C. And part of your issue for April 12th is just mitochondrial DNA, things that comes down through the mother's lineage. Is Aries a fire sign?
Unfortunately.
Yes.
Well, you could use a candle just to go into the candle fire and become your own. But air, people could use a fan, or earth, use a plant. And that'll easily, quickly help you return to who you are. But we also have a way to teach people about their own sounds and how to listen to this. It's called signature sound in olden literature, to listen to the sounds of your ears. And that it's titled, If You Can Moan, You Can Tone. And you can train yourself to listen to that sound, and that will take you back to center quicker than anything else.
That's so cool.
Well, it also helps the body heal, and it triggers the kundalini energy. But you can start with a very low sound and just move up the scale. And if you have your hands cupped over your ears and you do that, I'm going to get away from the phone and do it so you can see what I mean. And you go up and down the scale with your hands clapped over your ears or a pillow or something. At some point, your ears will ring back to you. That's your signature sound, or what they used to call a signature sound. Now we know it's the otoacoustic emission, and that's the sound that your body needs every moment to put you in a perfect harmony with your spirit, your mind, your body. And you'll get this little cleansing reaction if you keep listening to it. It's a deep cleansing breath. And the next thing you know, you're either asleep or you've astral projected. So you kind of have to prepare for what's going on.
Wow.
That's beautiful, though. That's beautiful. I love that. That's amazing. Mm-hmm. It's so simple.
In the chat room, Kendra's husband, Lars, wants to know if you could go through each zodiac sign real quick and tell us what the frequency is for each sign.
Sure. But it's on our site. go to the soundhealthoptions.com site and go to the downloads, and under Nano Voice, there is a chart there. And it'll start with C, and it'll give you a physical reaction as well as a physiological reaction. And I'll tell you, the notice C is for self. It's for large muscles. It's for Aries. Well, I don't think it says Aries. But C is for Aries. This goes right along with astrology. But you just double-click on that. It's called a note correlate chart. Then C-sharp is Taurus. That's about fairness and tendons and ligaments and the bowel and stubbornness. D is Gemini, liver, digestion, gallbladder, hormones. A lot of people's issues with weight are there because the leptin and adiponectin is not being made in the liver. D is about self-approval and wanting to serve other people and do for other people. They like to fix things and people and situations. D-sharp, sciatica, but also cancer, oxygenation of digestion, cell fire, the mitochondrial. These people are information brokers, like with Edward Snowden. He has D and D-sharp really high. He wants to help others with information. E is Leo. That's wet, moist tissues, oxygen, breathing, words, getting rid of bad things out of the body, either by breathing like carbon, oxygen in and carbon dioxide out kind of thing. It's verbal expression. These people can talk themselves out of things. They're self-sabotagers sometimes. And each of these have negatives. Like E people can be totally committed to more than one person at a time, and the rest of the signs don't understand that. They can be totally with different people at different times and totally be into them. Okay, F and F sharp is male sexuality together. It's also the balance between perception and actions, where F is the kidney, the bladder, environmental, breathing in issues. F is Virgo. They can be procrastinators or a workaholic. F and F sharp is also money. It's the lower back. So F sharp, that's Libra. Screening and filtering of everything, including relationships. They always want things to be good and wonderful and work hard to bring people together. Very partnership kind of thing with Pisces. Only Pisces has a more universal view, where the F-sharp person has a small community view of everything needs to be okay, copacetic. G, Scorpio, neurotransmitters, utilization of minerals, bones. It deals with physical prioritizing of the body. It deals with physical issues, like George Bush, when they threw the shoe at him, his G and G sharp showed really high, even though he said wasn't a bit scared. His vocal print said he was. G sharp is about enzymes, enzyme production, enzymes for reproduction, for digestion. They are Sagittarius. They can spread themselves too thin. They want to see that everything is managed on a physical level. G and G sharp is all about making things physically useful. Then A and A sharp is all about spirituality. A is about managing resources, making sure everybody gets what they need. Eyes, it's prioritizing what the body needs. And then A sharp is more a balance between E, chemical detoxifying, that's Aquarius. And then the note of B, which is either a martyr into themselves, whiny, or they can, if it's low, or it can be very, very high and they're into humanity. It's also subtle circulation, nerves, electrical body. And Sherry has a little bit of that going on, the electrical body thing. But if you could see all of these notes as, oh, I left out C and C sharp is female sexuality. If you could see this as food comes into the body at D, oxygen comes into the body at E, it burns at D sharp, and then C gets to say what's kept and what's not out of the bowel, the C sharp. Then it goes to the kidneys for quality inspection. Keep this, throw that out. G gets to store everything. People who have arthritis and the body just won't get rid of the stuff it doesn't need and stores it in all their little joints, that's G and G sharp. And then A and A sharp manages everything, who gets what, and then B delivers it. And with the nano voice, and there's also a set of sonar cards that tells each muscle that go with this and each toxin and each mineral that goes with each of these notes. And we go through that and talk about it in classes. And there's a two-hour class there for anybody who wants to learn the nano voice on their own. Almost everything we do can be self-taught, and our classes are online. And for anybody that's in your listening area right now, if they would like to come to our class starting next week, I will give them a matching scholarship.
Wow.
If they want to come to the class. Dollar for dollar, matching scholarship. Go to classes, which is just another link, and the class is a five-day class, and you click open, and it tells you how to prepare your computer, tells you what this is, it has a blue picture there. We're going to be doing eye watcher, allergies, migraines, circulation, inflammation, and anti-aging. And you can pick the softwares that you want. And there's a blue picture there that shows everything that you get with class. And it's 5 days, and it's grueling. But there's support afterwards, tutors. There's Sunday review classes. You can start your practice after this. We beat you to death for a week. But you can start your practice after that.
Now, I've got a quick question for you. I have an article about how a lot of people are hearing high-pitched frequencies that don't appear to be associated with tinnitus. I also hear them myself, and I know a lot of my readers on N5D do too. Is this a common theme, and typically how would you address this issue?
Two or three things. If it's damaged, it's going to be the same sound all the time. If you're hearing different sounds in different situations, you're probably hearing their signature sound or your own signature sound. And in that case, just get in a comfortable position, listen to the sound, and float away.
Wow, that's wonderful.
You know, some people are hearing harp sounds. And if that's the case, then we need to create a sound that will antidote that for them.
Mm-hmm. You mean harp with a two A's versus harp as the instrument?
Yes. The bad
I'm assuming the bad one.
Yeah, you know, okay. From cell towers and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That's
and
right.
Usually we just have people listen to their own birthday sounds.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if you'll be able to answer this question just yet, but I'll be taking a past life regression course in a few weeks with Kendra Gilbert and my girlfriend, Michelle, and it's called QHHT, which is a program developed by Dolores Cannon. Now, if a person was under hypnosis describing a previous life, and I took a nano voice on them under hypnosis, would the vocal print be from this current life or the energy of a previous life?
We've done that, and it's previous life, and we've also done dissociative.
Really?
And split personality.
Uh-huh. We're going to take this as far as we possibly can in every area of the metaphysics and spiritual realms, definitely.
It belongs to the people. We just need to pass it out.
Oh, that's so wonderful.
That's so cool.
Can you reverse aging through this technology?
We have. I'm 67, and I probably look 50 or so.
Mm.
Don't have a lot of gray hair yet.
You look wonderful. Definitely. What about for substance abusers or people on methadone? Can they use that as an alternative?
We have two programs, one called recreational drugs and the other called just medications. But it depends. What do they want to do with it? Like somebody comes in and they have a lot of marijuana in their system. You want to use it up or you want us to get rid of it? You know, And we can't create a reaction like cocaine unless they've had some of it to energize that in their body. So it depends on what they want to do with it.
Mm-hmm. Now, Andrew Fisher wanted to ask you if you're familiar with the work of Dr. Royal Rife, who used
resonance
frequency.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
He did square waves to kill pathogens. And square waves are killer waves, but you can also use sine waves in a way to create an artificial square wave. But Rife machines are great if you can get somebody who really knows how to use them. They will kill pathogens. Here's another thing that we discovered about pathogens. I'll try to make it real quick. Grapefruit seed extract. And we did this with our research about vaccinations. They put hematoglutinin in the vaccinations to make the viruses and the bacteria adhere to the cell more. There's an anti-hematoglutinin in grapefruit seed oil. And you can buy the Nutrabiotic brand is the most potent, and that will not allow pathogens to adhere to your cell. So people who have HIV or herpes or a lot of candida, using this grapefruit seed extract does a major die-off. So just an aside there, but yes, we can kill pathogens. And yes, Royal Rife was wonderful, and there's a lot of people out there using square waves, but they are killer waves. But there is a way to change the formula slightly to make it so it's not a killer wave for the person. But we get rid of herpes. We found that that's a basis of MS. There is so much. We have just skimmed the surface.
This is so exciting. Now, I have a quick question for you, too. I'm a huge introvert. Everyone that knows me knows that. And I get really nervous when I'm doing a radio show. So what if I'm interviewing or trying to get a nano voice from somebody or just a basic abacus voice print? Will that affect how it's being interpreted if they're nervous?
Probably will, but it'll tell you what they're nervous about. But you look at each the high notes, and that's where they're comfortable. If the C is high, they're comfortable about talking about themselves and their ego. If C sharp is high, they're comfortable with talking about the justice of what they're doing. And the D is high, they want to talk about how it helps others. Can you see how that works?
Yeah. No, it's all starting to click in now. Yeah.
So you can get good grades by watching how the professor talks, and then you know how to write your paper. Used to do that all the time. You know how to get along in an argument with your boss or how to approach your boss. You know what partners are compatible. I think we did some compatibilities when you were in class.
Yes.
And just looking at who you're going to get along with or where you're going to have trouble. We had a couple, and they were fighting all the time. And she had really, really high F and F sharp, and he practically had none. And I was able to say, she wants more sex than you do. And they were just flabbergasted because there it was right in their vocal print.
Now, I remember there was somebody in class that wanted to compare two people that were in a relationship. And I noticed that the male was showing marks that were high in ego. And a lot of people that I've been testing aren't showing any. Does that show that there's a deficiency? Do we actually need high marks in C or some marks in C to be normal?
First, there's nothing bad or good in someone's vocal print. It's what they do about it. So normal is 42, and if you look at the grid, just go halfway up, and that's normal. So if you have too much ego, you could have too much of the frequency that deals with physiology or ego, or you could have too much of the amino acid that is the note of C. I'm trying to look real quick and see what's going on with the note of C and see what the muscles are at the same time. So this is the allergy one. So people with too much C have a potential to have an allergy to peanuts. And too much C would be yellow dye. Bromelain, but it depends on what they're coming in to you for. and mm-hmm. what's really going on. They have a muscle that's a problem, then look at the muscles for that particular subtle card.
Now, to the people that are listening, you can download the Nano Voice software. This is what we're talking about right now for free on Sherry's website at soundhealthoptions.com. And we've been putting links to your website in the chat room, and I'll be putting this on YouTube, and I'll put a link in the more info section there so people can go to your website and check out everything that you're talking about.
Well, they could just jump into the happy hour tomorrow, too, and come see how it happens.
Mm-hmm. Sherrie Elisse, do you have any more questions?
I mean, I'm really stunned. This information is so exciting for me. When I was watching your video, Sherrie, of one of your interviews, it was so exciting for me that I actually started shaking because it was just the excitement was overwhelming for me because the information was so exciting and so interesting. And I thought, oh, my God. And it was so weird because then I looked at Carrie Cassidy, who was, you know, interviewing you, I looked and her subscribers were at 7777. Mm. And then, of course, that even freaked me out even more. So I thought, wow, I have to know this information. But it was so exciting. It actually made me start shaking because I was I thought it was one of the most interesting things that I've heard in such a long time. I mean, I've seen a lot of different alternative health things, but this was really new to me. So I find it so fascinating and amazing. You got me shaking. That was great.
Is that confirmation for you?
Mm-hmm.
Is that kind of thing confirmation?
When people have
that reaction, then I think some of this Templar information, and that was a sect of the Catholic Church that was charged with keeping people safe, whether it was health or traveling or whatever. And then King Philip tried to get rid of them and were burning some of them at the stake because they became very beloved. And somehow they instilled in the pattern of DNA things about the healing with sound and herbs. And I think when you have that reaction to this, you must be one of those descendants.
Wow.
It was so funny because I was telling my daughter, I was like, oh, my God. I was like, I'm tripping here. I'm tripping. I'm literally shaking and vibrating because I can't believe what I'm hearing. It was just so exciting.
Welcome home.
Yay. That's so exciting for me. Because that rarely happens because I've become sort of jaded to a lot of stuff, but this was literally just, I was vibrating, and I was like, wow, this is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
It was very cool. Thank you so much. This has been such a pleasure.
I still have a couple more questions, actually, if you don't mind.
That's fine. I just want to tell Sherrie Elisse that there is a book called Sound Secrets by Jill Mattson, and it has some of this ancient stuff in it, and you'll probably recognize some of it as you read about it. She is just this, she'd be a great guest for you. But she knows all this ancient stuff about ancient healing from every country and brought it in. And you'll start reading it and you'll recognize the words. You'll start shaking again when it comes to the part about where your healing knowledge genetics comes from.
Wow. I definitely will pick this up because I'm a musician also. Gregg and I are both musicians.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, definitely anything with music, sound, vibration, frequency, you know, we're on it.
Our DNA is set to music. Susan Alexandra has a CD called Sequentia, and it starts out with these four frequencies, A, B, C, D, and as they collide in sound, she brings them together and creates other notes, and it's haunting. You recognize it as something that's inside of you. It's incredible.
Mm-hmm.
Well, gosh, thanks so much for both of those. That's awesome. I can't wait to read her book and listen to that for sure.
Well, let me know what you think. Gregg, you had a couple more questions? Okay.
Yeah, I did. For the people, for the men out there who are balder or are balding, is there any software that would retrain the men the men's hair to regrow follicles, or even women
out
there.
It's called Hair Apparent.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
And it looks at DHT and biotin and all the things about hair follicles.
Mm-hmm.
It's there. There's a whole list of the software under downloads, and it says mm-hmm. software list. The first one in boxes, there's first 17 softwares, and those are what we give you to go teach classes in your community. And I think Hair Apparent's one of those.
Okay. And, well, I have another question. There's been different studies on music and frequency. I love hard rock, and in one of these studies, they actually proved that hard rock made the plants thrive, which I found very interesting. What are your studies saying about the frequencies and hard rock? How does that affect the person's vibration?
Well, you're really talking about scales and how musical notes are put together, and mm-hmm. everybody's is different. And the most lasting music, whether it's going to be country, classical, or hard rock, it has the perfect math. This note plus this note equals that note. You know, and you get into half notes and all that, and that's not the music that lasts. But every mm-hmm. scale is different for every human on the planet, and they've already decided that our frequencies for our scales come from the actual language. Like the note of A in France is different from the note of A in Germany because it's in the language. That's the bell curve of how people speak. I mean, there's just tons and tons of information. This is why when you're using bowls or tuning forks, you really need a way to tune to the person. Unless you want to take everybody to the chakra notes and everybody begins to be like everybody else. But everybody has their individual frequencies, their individual scales, their individual harmonics. And that's what your individual voice gives us, that pattern of harmonics. And from there, we look at you individually. And you don't have to even be here. You can do this over the computer. You can send us a computer file, and we can do it. That's the beauty of it. And then we can. There's a music list on our website. So if you need D sharp, then go play William Tell Overture.
Wow.
We made music in our own image of our own DNA.
Mm-hmm. Basically, then it's up to the individual to what kind of music they're listening to and how it makes them feel, regardless of what the music is.
Absolutely. If it floats your boat, listen to it.
I firmly believe that, too. You know, this has been such an amazing show, Sherrie, and I really can't wait. And I speak on behalf of Kendra, and I'm sure as well, Sherrie, and anybody else who's going to be taking this course, how much I'm looking forward to learning as much as I possibly can about this.
Well, get in touch with the office tomorrow and make some arrangements to get your stuff sent to you.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. And one more time, can you tell our listeners how to find you on the Internet?
Just Sound Health Options, or they can write to me, just my name at Gmail.
Okay. I can't thank you enough for being our guest on this show and helping humanity as much as you're doing. There's not enough words in human language to say thank you and show gratitude.
That is so sweet. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
No, yes, thank you. Thank you so much. I mean, I think you know how much we appreciate you. I'm sure you can feel it.
Mm-hmm.
What I feel from you is that you guys are in awe that you didn't know, and there's a big expansion opening up in front of you, and you want to fill it up with all this information.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's it. Yes, that's it.
And our chat room people are saying thank you. I don't know if you're following along on chat, Sherrie, but they're all thanking you and showing gratitude and excellent show. And I certainly look forward to working with you and getting this technology out to as many people as possible by taking as many classes as I can and through the holistic walk-in clinic that I hope to start here in Sarasota, Florida. working with as much of the technology that I can possibly learn. So thank you so much for being our guest tonight, Sherrie.
Yes, thank you so much.
You are most welcome. And thank everybody in chat. I love chats. But I didn't know what was going on, so or I would have jumped in.
Wonderful. Thank you once again, and I look forward to seeing you in class next week.
Well, I don't like goodbye, so later.
Bye.
Later.
All righty.
Later.
Now.
See ya.
Bye. Okay. Folks, that was Sherrie Edwards, and I hope you learned a lot out of this show. What was your impression, Sherrie?
Oh, I mean, it's amazing, amazing information that I so love the fact that she's made this available to everybody so that it's within their own control to be able to choose to use it to help themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So no one has to, you don't have to have money. You can just go on there, do it. You can find what you need, heal yourself. And it's within, like I said, it's within your own control. You don't have to go see a doctor and have them make an evaluation and go through the drug companies. I mean, here you have the perfect opportunity to have this opportunity to find out what your root cause of a problem is, which is amazing. How often can you find that out?
And I'll tell you what, you know, she's giving with her full heart on this, and she's coming from pure love and intention. And folks, get out there, jump on her website, sign up for these classes, and share this information with as many people as possible. We can change this world and make this an incredible place, a literal heaven on earth. It's up to us to do it. So get motivated, get out there and do it.
Yeah, and everybody has to find their tone. Everybody has to put their hands over their ears and do that so they can find their tone to bring them to that place of peace.
Mm-hmm. So we're going to wrap it up for tonight. On behalf of my co-host, Sherrie Elisse, this is Gregg Prescott from In5D. Namaste, everyone.
Bye.